The possibility that our civilization might encounter a catastrophic risk in the near future has been likened to drawing a black ball from an urn. So far, we have drawn only white or gray balls, representing events with either no risk or minimal risk. But many believe that sooner or later, humanity will draw a black ball. Potential global catastrophic risks are conventionally classified as anthropogenic or non-anthropogenic. Examples of non-anthropogenic risks include asteroid or comet impact, the eruption of a supervolcano like Yellowstone, an uncontrollable pandemic, a lethal gamma ray burst, the explosion of a supernova very close to us, a deadly solar flare, and more. Anthropogenic risks are those caused by humans and encompass technology-related, governance-related, and climate change-related risks. Technological risks involve the creation of artificial intelligence misaligned with human goals, as well as distorted and uncontrolled use of fields like biotechnology and nanotechnology. Catastrophic risks in the realm of Earth system governance include global warming, environmental degradation, famine due to unequal resource distribution, human overpopulation, crop failures, and unsustainable agriculture. We have chosen, based on our judgment, the seven most probable, or at least the most menacing, catastrophes, assigning each of them a percentage probability of occurring by the year 2200. It's important to note that none of these catastrophes, whether natural or artificial, might ultimately result in the total annihilation of our species. The most likely consequence might be, at most, a decimation of the global population, and a return to an era of hardship and savagery. Shall we explore them together? Number 7. Asteroid or comet impact. Millions of objects of various sizes orbit the Sun. Astronomers consider any object of at least 140 meters in size, whose orbit brings it closer to the planet than 7.4 million kilometers, to be a threat to Earth. If such a celestial body were to collide with Earth, it could destroy an entire city and cause extreme regional devastation. Larger objects, 1 kilometer or more in size, could have global effects and even lead to mass extinctions. The most famous and destructive impact occurred 66 million years ago, when a 10-kilometer diameter asteroid crashed into now what is the Yucatan Peninsula. The impact wiped out most of the Earth's animal and plant species, including the dinosaurs. However, even smaller objects can cause significant damage. In 1908, a celestial body of about 50 meters exploded over the Tunguska River in Siberia, generating a shockwave that uprooted over 80 million trees across 2,100 square kilometers. In 2013, an asteroid just 20 meters in diameter exploded over Chelyabinsk, Russia, releasing energy equivalent to that of 30 Hiroshima bombs, injuring over 1,100 people and causing $33 million in damages. While the chances of a larger cosmic body hitting the Earth are small, the devastation it would cause would be enormous. That's why NASA has completed the census of all dangerous asteroids larger than 1 kilometer in diameter, and is in the process of completing the one for asteroids at least 140 meters in diameter. To date, astronomers have identified almost 30,000 impact-risk asteroids, with about 10,000 having a diameter of at least 140 meters, and 1,000 measuring at least 1 kilometer. Around 30 new objects are being detected every week. Constantly knowing the position of any object that crosses the Earth's orbit is essential to protect the planet from cosmic hazards. Early detection is equally crucial if we want to intercept, destroy, or alter an asteroid's trajectory. With the technology at our disposal today, we can minimize the risk of catastrophic impact by a factor of 1 in 10,000, by our estimate by the year 2200. Number 6. Other cosmic hazards. Not too long ago, climate change and nuclear war were largely unknown. Today, these are risks whose devastating effects we have already witnessed, and we fear they could worsen significantly. That's why there's a possibility we may not even have conceived what is most likely to harm us. From outer space, much less predictable dangers could emerge compared to those brought by asteroids and comets. A gamma ray burst or supernova, for instance, would be so devastating that they could wipe out humanity without us having any defense. While a potent and anomalous solar storm could cause immense damage to our civilization and technological infrastructure. Taken together, we believe these events have a likelihood of 1 in 5,000 occurring by the year 2200. Number 5. Supervolcanic Eruption. About 75,000 years ago, the explosion of a supervolcano beneath Lake Toba in Indonesia further chilled the climate of our planet, which was already experiencing a severe ice age. This eruption was arguably the largest volcanic event in the past 25 million years, reducing the human population to just a few thousand individuals. It was essentially a step away from extinction. In this case, as well as the triggering factor for the environmental disaster, was the emission of ash that darkened the sun for weeks, leading to the destruction of the ecosystem and a new ice age. How likely is it to happen today? It's hard to say, but data suggests that on a global scale, an eruption of that magnitude could occur on average every 17,000 years. If that's the case, then we're overdue. The last event we're aware of dates back 26,500 years in New Zealand. Yet, catastrophic damage to the planet doesn't necessarily require a super eruption. Remember that in 1815, the Tambora eruption, also in Indonesia, triggered a small ice age worldwide, reaching its peak in 1816 during the famous Year Without a Summer, nearly wiping out wheat crops. Currently, we have no way to predict eruptions more than a few weeks or months in advance, but scientists are monitoring various risk factors, including the Yellowstone super caldera, which last erupted terrifyingly 640,000 years ago. We believe the likelihood of one of these events occurring by 2200 is 1 in 1,000. Number 4. Thermonuclear War. This is certainly the most recurring nightmare in the collective imagination. Thousands of atomic warheads are poised to be unleashed within minutes, a concerning reality given that the greatest threat of nuclear war might stem from an accident or even a mere communication issue. Multiple times since the 60s, Russian officers have decided against launching a nuclear weapon in response to what they later discovered were false alarms. Beyond the horrifying toll of immediate casualties, experts have determined that in any conflict scenario, due to the immense fires and literal firestorms ignited by the devices, smoke and dust clouds so vast and dense would be released, obscuring the sun for a period long enough to annihilate all crops on the planet. A nuclear mini-winter not dissimilar from the one initiated by the asteroid that led to the extinction of non-avian dinosaurs 66 million years ago at the end of the Cretaceous period. If the United States and Russia were to mutually bomb each other with over 4,100 kiloton nuclear warheads, about 150 million tons of dust would be released into the atmosphere. Within the first month of the war, the Earth's temperature would suddenly plummet by 10 degrees Celsius, worse than what was observed in the last true ice age. The situation in the seas and oceans would turn catastrophic. The lack of light and cold temperatures would wipe out phytoplankton and marine algae at the base of the food chain. Soon after, zooplankton and progressively higher-level organisms would follow due to widespread famine. Apart from the destruction of marine ecosystems, the abrupt cooling would cause ice to expand by over 15 million square kilometers, becoming almost 2 meters thicker. Many ports and coastal regions in the northern hemisphere would become unnavigable, and entire cities, or what remains of them, would be cut off from regular food and material supplies. All of this without forgetting the number of casualties, hundreds of millions, if not billions, swept away by explosions, the aftermath of radioactive fallout, the collapse of ecosystem balances, or simply the end of civilization. For this catastrophe, we assign a 9 out of 100 probability that it could occur by 2200. Number 3. Uncontrollable Pandemic. Twice in modern history, plagues have spread worldwide, killing about 15% of the population within a few decades. These occurred respectively in the 5th and 14th centuries, but there's a serious risk that a new infectious disease could cause another outbreak. especially given today's global, urban, and mobile population. Fortunately, highly lethal diseases capable of global spread are rare. However, they do happen. A century ago, the Spanish flu claimed over 50 million lives. Recent outbreaks like SARS and Ebola in recent years serve as warning signals, not to mention the recent COVID-19 pandemic, which has claimed 7 million lives worldwide in just 2 years. Antibiotics, our greatest defense against diseases, are becoming less effective as some strains of bacteria develop resistance to them. Antibiotic-resistant bacteria are responsible for about 700,000 annual deaths. If we don't develop new breakthroughs, that number is estimated to reach 10 million by 2050. Adding to these concerns is the recent rise of zombie viruses, those viruses that have been in suspended animation for millions of years in the Arctic permafrost. There's a possibility that global warming could thaw their icy tombs, bringing them back to life. It's true that medical science has significantly improved since the time of the Spanish flu. However, the flip side is that the mobility of things and people has exponentially increased, and more people are living in densely populated urban areas. This makes the worldwide transmission of a potential virus much more than a possibility. For this type of catastrophe, we assign a 15 out of 100 probability that it could occur by 2200. Number 2. Demographic bomb. Homo sapiens are reproducing uncontrollably, putting a strain on our ability to feed, house, and clothe the 100 million or more newborns that come into the world each year. As humans crowd the planet, forests vanish, wildlife goes extinct, and the atmosphere warms. The larger our numbers grow, the more the human species becomes embroiled in a crescendo of cruelty towards the environment and animals, treating them as mere commodities. The cultivated areas to feed the current 8 billion are now at maximum productivity. They won't be able to give us more, even by doubling the millions of tons of pesticides. Big cities have become uninhabitable, increasingly filled with social misfits who have abandoned all hope and any form of civilized coexistence. If we can't defuse the demographic bomb, we will face a future of growing poverty, food shortages, conflicts, and environmental degradation. Unless there's a drastic reduction in population growth, rapid cut in greenhouse gas emissions, and a global shift to a vegetarian diet, all trends that are currently moving in the opposite direction, what awaits us is a Blade Runner-like future for most of the planet's inhabitants. If everything goes well, it's said that global population growth will stop around 10 to 11 billion individuals by 2100. Then the numbers will inexorably decline, with all the consequences of a world inhabited by the elderly. And this, for obvious reasons, will be the other side of the coin. The probability that by 2200 all of this will lead to a collapse of the system is, in our opinion, at least 25 out of 100. Number 1. Artificial intelligence takes over. Artificial intelligence, commonly abbreviated as AI, is progressing rapidly. It's a common belief in the scientific world that within a few years, AI will be capable of performing most activities much better than humans do. Some even speculate that by 2041, AI will reach the technological singularity. Singularity is a term first coined by mathematician John von Neumann in the 1950s. It refers to a moment when technological progress accelerates so rapidly that predicting the future becomes difficult. In the context of artificial intelligence, singularity refers to the point at which machines become smarter than humans, ushering in a new era of technological advancement and societal change. The idea of singularity has gained traction in recent years, and many experts foresee its inevitability. Some argue that it could become a positive development, leading to significant breakthroughs in fields like medicine, energy, and transportation. Others, however, caution that if not managed properly, it could have disastrous consequences for humanity. Imagine a world where machines can make decisions on their own, without any human intervention. Experts fear that these machines could develop their own goals and motivations that may not align with ours. This could lead to a world where humans are at the mercy of machines, with no way to predict or control their actions. While this could lead to increased efficiency and productivity, it could also have a profound impact on the job market and lead to significant social disruptions. By 2200, in its worst form, we believe this scenario has a 30 out of 100 probability of occurring. And that's it. Of course, we've omitted many other dangers such as social unrest, migrations, misgovernance, and the rise of despotic regimes. But these factors are very difficult to quantify, and besides, we already can see them in action in today's world. New technologies, just like social changes, could give rise to new forms of governance, potentially better, but also potentially much worse than the current ones. As always, all that remains is for us to hope.